Hi there! Integza again! And if you are watching this video without having seen the question 1, please click the annotation. Now, if we're gonna answer this question with some degree of certainty, we first need to understand how a fridge works. And if it's a common fridge, its secret is behind the fact that temperature, pressure and volume are intrinsically linked. Now, to better understand this love triangle, let's look at the following example. Imagine a flask that is filled with air and tightly sealed by a piston. This volume of air is at a certain pressure and temperature. In this case, don't give too much importance to the values themselves, but rather their variation. As in this moment, my friend Boris drops a big rock on top of the piston.
My name is not Boris, and I am not your friend.
Anyway, because of the weight of the rock, the air will be pushed down, decreasing its volume and increasing its pressure and temperature. That's right, temperature rises because of the compression. It's by using this effect that diesel engines work. The fuel-air mixture is compressed, increasing the temperature so much that the mixture ignites itself. But because the glass is not the best insulating material, it allows the air to give off energy to the environment surrounding it, cooling down to the previous temperature. Now, if we made the rock disappear, the air would decompress and get to its initial conditions. Except, it would be missing one thing: the energy it gave off moments ago. So, with this decompression, the air would absorb the exact amount of energy previously lost. The lesson we take from here is we can control energy transfer by controlling these three fundamental properties. For a more practical example, let's analyze a fire extinguisher. This one is packed with 2 kilograms of carbon dioxide, what means it has about 1 cubic meter of carbon dioxide compressed in it. If this is true, maybe I can remove enough energy from this bottle to freeze the water. Or I could, if the fire extinguisher didn't run out. I really can't understand why it ran out. I have no clue. Now that we have established some fundamental concepts, let's observe how our refrigerator works. All begins in the mighty compressor. It pumps the refrigerant at high pressure and temperature. But we don't want high temperature refrigerant, so we give off energy to the room. A cooler but still high pressure fluid enters the expansion valve, and as the obvious name indicates, it decompresses the fluid. Now, do you remember what happens when you decompress a high pressure fluid? Yes! You are completely right! Absorbs energy. In this case, energy from the bananas and the ham. Now we have banana ham energy we don't really want, so we dump it in the room. Okay, so we take the energy from the food and dump it into the room. By this logic, the room should get hotter, right? Wrong! If you remember, in the case of the question, the refrigerator's door is open, what means the energy that is taken from the food is also taken from the room. It's a vicious cycle, you see? The energy that goes out is the same that comes in. This cycle doesn't change the temperature of the room. So, finally, we can conclude that the temperature of the room doesn't change.
Nah,
we can't, because we are forgetting a tiny detail. The compressor is a machine that turns electrical power into movement. And because there's no such a thing as a perfect machine, a part of this electrical power is transformed into heat at a constant rate, because the compressor is always working. So, finally, and this time is for real, the room gets hotter. Now, if you really think that I am wrong and you have a different perspective, please explain it in the comment section. This is everything for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I also hope that you learned something new. I also hope that you subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.